Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Like the science is not attributed to a person. Science is attributed to principles. It's not that the law of gravity is applicable only on the Britishers and not on the Indians. Because it is a principle. It has nothing to do with the person. Similarly, if it is Ayurveda, it doesn't mean it will apply only on Hindus. See? If it is Yunani medicine, it doesn't mean it is useful and meaningful only for the Muslims. No. Wherever person is important and not the principle, obsession and duragraha comes. But when we talk about principle, then all the differences disappear. Because principles are not based on persons. Principles based on the facts as it is. Therefore, what is the principle that we are going to talk? There are two principles which are used to deal with life. First principle is Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. Everything is Paramatma. Ishavasya says, Ishavasyamidam Sarvam Yat Kincha Jagatyam Jagat. Everything is the divine. This is one principle, which we can call for our understanding as all-inclusive principle. Nothing is excluded. Because yat kincha jagatyam jagat, whatever may be the most insignificant, everything is ishavasyam, permeated by the isha, the divine, the God, whatever you call. The second principle is brahma satyam jagan mithya jivo brahmaiva naparaha. Second principle is the Brahman, the reality, is the truth, and the world which appears is an illusion. Now, if you bring these two principles together, what will be the effect? First, everything is Brahman. Second, the world is an illusion. So, if everything is Brahman, that means the world also, and the world is illusion, therefore Brahman is illusion. So we have to understand it in a proper way. And once we understand this, then the principles of life will be easy for us to practice. So, whatever we have accepted as an illusion, what is our interaction with the illusions? So let us take one or two illusions. First illusion, the sky is blue. So, even if we know, the sky will continue to appear as blue. It is not for the ignorant person the sky is blue, and for the scientist it looks white. No. It is blue for a person who knows and who doesn't know. Now, if I do not know, what will be my approach? My approach will be, I don't like blue color. I like pink color. So my whole life will be trying to change the color of the sky, which will never happen. But when I know that it is only an appearance and it is not real, what will be my interaction? I will not get disturbed by the appearance of the blue color, although I don't like it. See? Take another example. The rainbow is also an illusion. It appears, but it doesn't exist. So when we look at the rainbow, do we desire? Let me take a piece of rainbow for my wife. No. And second thing, We don't feel miserable when we see the rainbow. Oh God, rainbow digya. No. So, whenever we look at the world as an illusion, two things must happen. Then our knowledge is pakka. The first thing is, we don't suffer in this world. Because it is illusion. And the second thing is, we don't desire anything. These two things. Now, the first principle that we saw, that everything is Paramatma, then we desire only that which is other than the self. Like, eyes can see everything other than themselves. Eyes can't see themselves. Similarly, we don't desire us because I am me. How can I desire? Desire is only about that which I don't have. See? Like, for example, you are married. You cannot have desire for wife. You are already suffering. See? And if somebody is not married, I don't give my example. If somebody is not married, he will think, you know, one person went to an astrologer. And there was a queue, and he was waiting, waiting. Finally, his number came. And he said, Maharaj, I want to get married, but why my marriage is not happening? So the Panditji saw for quite long. And have you paid your fees? No, pay fee first. So he took his charge and then he said, you cannot get married. Why? Because there is Akhanda Ananda Yoga. So desire is possible if only something is recognized as other than the self. Now put both the principles together. The world is an illusion, or I, the Brahman, the reality, is the world. Now in both the cases, the net result will be freedom from desires. If we are carrying any kind of desire, then we are still leading a life of relative existence and have not attained the absolute freedom. Now this is the principle. And therefore, you will see, once you take this principle, then the second step on the spiritual path is, we have to start learning from every experience of our life. This is the rule. See, friends. Every experience is meant for us to learn. But normally what happens? Instead of learning, we react. And when we react, there are impressions formed on our mind. And impressions are only two. I like something, I dislike something. And this has been our going on for ages together. As a result, our mind is carrying initially two hair-thin lines of likes and dislikes. And this is continuously propagated, supported. And then we come to a point that our initial hair-thin lines have become the furrows and valleys. As the age grows, our personal likes and dislikes become so strong that we cannot go beyond it. And further, what we call prosperity? Prosperity is more and more support for our personal likes and dislikes. Thereby, we are seeking more options. See? And we give ourselves more choices. Therefore, if we learn, what will happen? If we learn, our mind remains without any good or bad impressions. See? These likes and dislikes have no logic. See, for example, I like red color. And other person likes green color. Now what is the logic? Both of them have no logic. But our whole life is guided by the likes and dislikes, and we consider ourselves to be very intelligent. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is freedom from the influence of desires. And then what happens? Then we learn how to interact with the life or with the world so that we are not a problem for ourselves and we are not a problem for the world. See, very simple. Now take the example to understand this. In our childhood, sometime we have touched fire. As a child we didn't know, we touched fire. That time we got burnt. Thereafter we have learned that the fire burns. And therefore, we do not hate fire, we do not love fire, because we have learned. Thereafter, what do? Now, with that wisdom, we decide now how to interact with the fire so that the burning ability of the fire is to our benefit. Same way, when we learn about this world, and when we learn from every experience of our life, what will happen? Will be freedom from the desire, and we will learn how to manage ourselves in this given world. See how simple it is. Now this process of learning, I'll tell you how it has helped me. Once I was going with my friend in a car in Delhi. And there was a taxi going in front. My friend says, "Swamiji, see, that fellow's door is open, he may fall down. I'll take the car parallel, you tell him to close it." So I had to listen to everybody, so I went. And when the car was parallel, he said, "Now you can tell him." So I put down the glass and told him, "Hey Mahatmaji, your door is open, please close it, you will fall down." "Who asked you? Mind your business." When he said like this, my friend became very angry. He said, "How bad he is, doesn't have manners. We are telling for his benefit." And the way he said, I said, "Don't scold my guru. He is my guru. He has taught me, don't get involved in anybody's life unless invited." We get so much involved in majority of the family problems. With due respect to your age, it is the elders who are the problems in the family. They don't want to change. They are living 1857. See, friends. And therefore, they suffer in life. And not only, they make others suffer. See, friends, this is only because obsession. Therefore, when they tell something, the children don't listen and they get frustrated. See, we are telling for their benefits. They should learn from my experience. Experience cannot be transferred. I cannot say, "I have eaten rasgulla, it's very good, you don't have to take, all right?" No, but I told you it is very good. That is not enough. I have to have my experience. See, friends. In this manner, when we start learning from our experiences, then that learning process will reduce the desire burden on our mind. Because we have learned. And what are the signs of a wise man? Gatasuna gatasuscha nanu shochanti panditaha. Wise men are never miserable. Otherwise men are never happy. So whenever we are miserable, understand we are going the wrong way. See, friends. Now keeping all this in mind, now let us enter this text, Vijnana Bhairava. Now about studying the scriptures, I'll tell you my approach. What you are doing is right. I'll tell you my approach. I am not interested in academics. Absolutely not interested. How does it matter from which tree the mango has come? Are kaat ke kha jao yaar. Why worry? See. So, once it happened in US, somebody's place I was invited for lunch, and then there were about 20-25 people in somebody's basement. And then they say, Swamiji, he is so and so, he has come from India and he is teaching us Gita for last 6 months regularly. I said, very good. Swamiji, you talk something on Gita. I said, no, I will also listen. Let him speak, I will also like to learn. He said, no, you tell Swamiji. You come once in a while, we are listening him every day. So I had to talk. Then that gentleman said, elderly man, he said, Swamiji, talk on second chapter of Gita. Now I have to respect the guest. So I finish second chapter in 1 hour. Then he said, question answer. I said, I don't enter in question answer. No, please, one question at least. Again the same man said. I said, okay, only one question. But I said, remember, when I answer, I don't enter in discussions and arguments. Two things should be over. Okay, then he asked the question. See, what was the question? How many verses are attributed to Dhritarashtra, Sanjay, Arjun and Bhagwan Krishna in Bhagavad Gita? Academics. So I said, I don't know. This is why what I learned from my guru, I told you. My gurus are all the NRI children from America. They cannot talk one straight sentence. You ask them anything. Hey, what do you want to plan to do in your life? Like Om Bhur Bhuvasva. Then the mantra begins. So, I don't know. Same principle I have followed. He said, how come you don't know you are teaching Gita? I said, okay, listen. One verse is attributed to Dhritarashtra. Yes. And no verse is attributed to Bhagavan Sri Krishna. When I said like this, he nearly jumped out of his skin. What? Not a single verse to Bhagavan Sri Krishna? I said, yes, not a single verse. How come you say? I said, show me your Gita. So he showed Gita praise book. This is the Gita. I said, show me where Sri Bhagavan Uvacha. So, Sri Bhagavan Krishna Uvacha. Nowhere. Bhagavan Uvacha. Bhagavan could be anybody. Bhagavan Ram, Bhagavan Shiva. There was one Hindi actor, Bhagavan. Bhagavan Uvacha. I said, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, you see, throughout Bhagavad Gita, never he mentioned himself as Devaki Putra. What he said, Ajopi San Navyatma Bhutanam Ishwaropi San, although unborn, Sri Krishna was born. Although unborn. Don't go into academics. By going into academics, you will get one degree and get one promotion. It has nothing to do with the truth. See, this Brahma Vidya is not meant for filling your belly. You get anyway. It is for some higher purpose. And therefore, we have to get out of this approach of academics. I am absolutely not interested in academics. Therefore, many people, when they ask about Yoga Vasishtha, in Yoga Vasishtha, so many stories come which appeared to have happened after Bhagavan Krishna came. So Yoga Vasishtha was told to Rama in the Treta Yuga. Bhagavan Krishna's story came in this Dwapara Yuga. How it is possible? I said, I don't know. Over. Learn, learn, learn. Scriptures are meant for us to learn from, not argue and dissect them. So, who is the writer of Vijnan Bhairava? When it was written? How it was written? I am not interested. So all problems over. Otherwise arguments begin. And arguments is not the spiritual path. Submission to the truth is the spiritual path. So, this Vijnan Bhairava is a dialogue between Shiva and Parvati, Devi. And see here, it's a very peculiar thing. What is this science? It is called as Chidvilas or Ishvara Advayavad. There are two principles mainly, which I told you. Bhagavan Shankaracharya has explained the whole Vedanta on the foundation of Shlokardhena Pravakshami Yaduktam Grantha Koti Vihi Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jivo Brahmai Vanaparaha. What is said in millions of books, I shall tell you in half the shloka. Shlokardhena Pravakshami. What did he say? Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya and Jivo Brahmai Vanaparaha. This is the conclusion of all the scriptures. See? And this is one approach to the reality. The other approach is Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma, everything is expansion of Brahman. Now both these principles, both these philosophy followers, they are headlong with each other. See, the Shankara's followers, they say it's all rubbish. And these followers say, Shankara is telling mithya, mithya, there is nothing mithya, everything is real. And both of them are not ready to understand the standpoint, from what standpoint they are saying this. See, friends, I was a victim of this many years before. Once I was attending somebody in a hospital for cancer, and That time, somebody came to meet me and he said, Swamiji, what do you do your whole day? I said, nothing, I sleep and eat. He said, no, I'll give you some book, you may like it, to read. So he gave me one book, composition of Santa Ganeshwar, Amrutanubhav. So I read that. And while reading it, I came across one very peculiar statement, that knowledge is bondage, jnanam bandha. And that has shaken me completely, because all what I have been studying was rute jnananna mukti, without knowledge there is no freedom. And it has shaken me so badly, I became very uneasy. You can't take the statement of such a great master as rubbish. This has to have some meaning. And then, after a few months or a year, but it was going in my mind, how it is possible? So I had been to Ganeshpuri, Nityananda Baba's place, for darshan. From Bombay, it is about 30-40 kilometers. So when I went there, one British lady happened to meet me and came. She said, Swamiji, last time I had given you a nice scarf, you gave it to somebody, because that person told me, see, Swamiji gave me this thing. I felt so bad, I gave it to Swamiji, he passed on to somebody. So I had decided not to give you anything. I said, don't give, who cares? He said, no, I will give you a book. When you give a book to somebody, nobody wants, so you will keep it with yourself. So, she gave me a book, and the book was Shiva Sutra. So I said, what is the Shiva Sutra? I know Narad Bhakti Sutra, I know Brahma Sutra. I don't know what is Shiva Sutra. So I just happened to open randomly. And there was that sutra, knowledge is bondage. As if the answer was given to me. And then I started studying it deeply, completely. And thereafter, my conclusion was, this is what I told you. When you take this world as an illusion, you are free from the virus of desire. When you take this world as expansion of the truth, you are free from the desires. So if you observe this approach, that the cause is never known. From the effect, the cause is deducted. Like when we go to the doctor, we tell them the symptoms. These are the symptoms. We don't tell the disease. See? Like yesterday when I went to the dentist, so what is wrong with you? I said, wrong is, this is what happens. And then they found out why this is happening. So from the symptoms, the cause is established. So what are the symptoms? Objectivity is the symptom. Because we know this world. Now from this known world, we have to know the cause. So we are told, what is the cause of this world? So one approach is, God created this world. Second approach is, God alone is appearing as the world. See, meaning is the same. But we start fighting with each other. And thereafter, I started studying all these books. And it is so simple and straight. There are no contradictions anywhere. This is how this Vijnana Bhairava came in my hand and we studied it. Now, here also we'll try to study something. Maybe we are benefited, who knows, by mistake many things happen. Sri Devi Uvacha Shrutam Deva Maya Sarvam Rudra Yamala Sambhavam Trig Bheda Masheshena Sarat Saram Vibhagashah Adhyapina Nivrutome Samshayaha Parameshwara Kim Rupam Tatvato Deva Shabdarashi Kalamayam Kim Va Navatma Bhedena Bhairave Bhairava Akrutau Trishiro Bheda Vinnamva Kim Va Shaktitrayatmakam Nada Bindumayam Vapi Kim Chandrardha Nirodhika Chakra Ruda Manaskancha Kim Va Shakti Swarupakam Paraparaya Sakalam Aparaya Shavapunaha Paraya Yadi Tadvat Syat Paratvam Tadvirudhyate Nahi Varna Vivedena Deha Bhedena Vabhaved Paratvam Nishkalatvena Sakalatvena Tadbhaved Prasadam Kurumenatha Nishesham Chiddi Samshayam. These are the 6-7 verses which are the questions asked by Devi Parvati to Lord Shiva. See. Now what is the meaning of Bhairava and what is the meaning of Vijnana? See, Vijnana means experience gained through application of knowledge. Knowledge is law of gravity. Application is landing of the spacecraft on the moon. So that is based on the principle of gravity. So first of all, that shuttle has to be thrown out of the area of the gravity, then it will go and land. So knowledge and application leading to experience is called as Vijnanam. So we all know Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya, so what? We all know everything is Paramatma, so what? So are we having experience of that? Or only we are talking without an experience? See, friends, therefore, Vijnana is not only knowledge, erudition or scholarship, but experience attained through this knowledge by application of this. So how to apply, this is the technique given in this book, Vijnana. Then what is the meaning of Bhairava? Bhairava has three words, bha, ra and va. Bha, bharanat bhairava, vamanat bhairava, or ravanat bhairava. Bhairava. So, vamana means bringing out. Like when somebody vomits, so he brings out. What he brings out? What he has eaten. One boy has eaten some money. No, I have not taken anything. But they have seen that he has eaten some money, few coins. So they put the salt water and bring it out. No, it is not from me. See, it has not come from anywhere. It was already there. Similarly, this world is not created. It is the manifestation of already existing. Therefore, in our scriptures, there is no acceptance that world is created. World is unmanifest, becomes manifest, again becomes unmanifest. Bhagavan says in second chapter of Gita, avyakta dini bhutani vyakta madhyani bharata avyakta didana neva tatraka paridevana. The whole world is already unmanifest, it becomes manifest, it goes back again. Nothing is created in this world. So, vamanat bhairava. Second is, bharanat bhairavaha bha. Bharan means the one who is sustaining this world. See? And ra means ravanat, means absorption. See? Rumination, same word. So, ravanat, it is absorption. In Vedanta Shastra, the same thing is said by using different words. But when both of them become obsessed, they say, no, Brahman, or only Bhairava. And is Brahman pure? No, no Bhairava, only Brahman. Don't do jagadaya, meaning is the same. So what is said in Vedanta, it is sarga srushti sthiti laya. Srushti is vamanam, nirman. And sthiti is the bharana. And laya is the ravana. Meaning is the same, it's not different. So the same Paramatma, which is called as Brahman in Vedanta, then Paramatma in Yoga, and Bhagavan in Bhakti Shastra is called as Bhairava in this Yoga Shastra. They are not different. But we get so lost only in the words and forget the meaning. So, Vijnana Bhairava. So, experience of this absolute non-dual presence. How do we attain is the theme of this text. Heard we have many times, but are we having an experience of it? And if we have the experience, what are the symptoms? You can't go and ask anybody, will you please tell me how much I have come up in realization? People ask us, I am not manufacturing questions. One lady asked me in Delhi, Swamiji, please don't quote my example anywhere. I said, okay, I will not quote. And then said, Swamiji, how far I have come in realization on spiritual evolution? I said, stand properly. And then I said, up to knee you have come. You have to grow further. See, friends, therefore, this is the subjective experience. You don't have to ask anybody. Or else I go and take food and I ask, hey, excuse me, please tell me my stomach is full or not. Nobody can tell. Therefore, Vijnana Bhairava is your personal immediate experience, which doesn't require authentication by certification from anybody. Vijnana Bhairava. Now, Devi asked this question, Sri Devi Vach. Shrutam deva maya sarvam rudra yamala sambhavam. Now here a list of many approaches to the reality is indicated. Like we have got in our Dharma Shastra, Veda, not one four of them. Upanishad, not one hundreds of them. Puranas, not one 18 of them. Shruti, not one 18 of them. Then Itihas, not one two of them, Mahabharata and Ramayana. And Mahatmas, not one, they are thousands. So who is right? See? If there is only one God, one book, one day and one everything, no disturbance, no, then go like a bullock. Like a bullock goes round and round and round, like that. And if somebody brings more, kill it. No. So here, the Devi asks, I have heard many of them, sarvam rudra yamala sambhavam, phir trik, bheda, and sarasara vibhagashaha. Therefore, rudra yamala tantra and all the secrets of the trik philosophy. Trik, T-R-I-K, we write in English, but it's trik. Trik is the three, pashu, pati, and nath. In Nepal, there is a Shiva temple, Pashupati Nath. Pashu is the Jiva, Pati is the Ishvara, and Nath is Parameshvara. So, this principle I have heard sarasara vibhagashaha with exhaustive details I have heard. Adyapi no nivrutya me samshaya Parameshvara, and he Parameshvara, and yet my doubts are still lingering around because kim rupam tattvato deva Shabda Rashi Kalamayam. So, what is the essence of the Divine Self? Is it the words Brahma? Is this the reality? Or Bhagavan? Is this the reality? Or Bhairava? Shabda Rashi Kalamayam. Is the Paramatma expressing as the words? Or further, Kim Navatma Bhedena? There are 9 expressions of the reality. Is that? Or Tri Shiro Bheda Bhindamva? There are 3 heads, Jagra, Sapna, Sushupti, 3 persons, or Shakti Trayatmakam, or is it an assembly of the 3 powers, the Rajas, Sattva, Tamas, or Nada Bindumayam Vapi, or this Paramatma is the Bindu expressed as the Kala and then become Nada, is this the Paramatma? So, Kim Chandrarka Nirodhika, those who are practicing, they know when one comes to the Agya Chakra, hereafter, from here up to the Brahmarandra, there are 9 stages one has to go through. In that, the first stage is Chandrarka. Here it is Chandrakala, and then Nirodhika, and there are 7, 8, 9 of them. And then you transcend the Brahmarandra and enter the totality, the divine. So is that the reality that you are talking about? Or Kim Shakti Swarupakam, or is it the undivided principle of energy? Kindly tell. So these are about 6 questions she has asked. Therefore, Paraparaya Sakalam Aparayasya Vapunaha Paraya Yadi Tadvasyan Paratvam Tadvirudyate. Is the supreme reality both the Parashakti or Aparashakti, or is it both? If it is both, then how it is possible to be both? It can be only one. Apara means which is manifest, and para is beyond manifestation. How can the same thing be simultaneously the transcendental and the immanent? Kindly tell me. I am unable to comprehend the truth. So, prasadam kuru me natha nishesham chindi samshayam. Please bless me so that all my doubts are gone. We all have doubts, and this is the samsara. Now, before I go here, I give you right away the experience that you are. Questions and doubts are always about something other than the self. So if you want to practice meditation, what you should do? That about which you have no question and no doubt is the truth. Now work. Now what will be the work? Work will be find out what is that about which I have no question and no doubt. We will come to one point. We have no question and no doubt about our being, whether I am or I am not. If this is the truth, why go and asking how to do meditation and tell me quickly, I don't have time? So is meditation preparing upma? Cut vegetables first. It is not an action. Experience is not an action. Bodha is not an action. Bodha means experience. Experience does not depend on the means of experience or the means of knowledge. For example, how many people are here? 100 people. How do you know? No, I thought. No, you have seen. I have not seen. Then you are bluffing. So, knowledge is always gained through the valid means of knowledge. If a blind person talks about the beauty of a girl, he is bluffing. See, he can't. He has not seen. So for colors and forms, the sense organs are essential means of knowledge. For joy and sorrows, the means of knowledge is mind. For concepts and evaluation, the intellect is the means of knowledge. But I am, our being, is not gathered through sense organs, the mind or the intellect. When all of them are closed, like in deep sleep, yet we do not experience our absence. And therefore, a person who is awake, he makes the statement, I had a good sleep, but in between bad dreams. Now who makes this statement? This statement cannot be made by a waker because he was absent in the deep sleep. This statement cannot be made by a waker because he was not in the dream. And yet this statement is made by every one of us. Like this morning when I got up late, 6 o'clock I wake up, very late for me. So, yesterday was a very long day and tiring, and therefore I slept like a wooden log. And I got up, I had no dreams. Now who is making this statement? Not the waker, the I, but the one who was there in the deep sleep but did not sleep, who was in the dream but did not dream, who is the waking but he is not a waker. This experience doesn't require any effort. This experience is not created. And therefore, there is no fear of loss of this experience. See? Therefore, nishesham chindi samshayam. Kindly remove all my doubts about this experience of being. Now, Sri Bhairava Uvacha. Sadhu sadhu tvaya prushtam tantra saramidam priye guhaniya tamam bhadre tathami kathayamite yatkinchit sakalam rupam bhairavasya prakirtitam tadasarataya devi vidneyam shakrajalavat maya sapnopamam chaiva gandharo nagarabhramam dhyanartham bhranta buddhinam kriyadambaravartinam kevalam varnitam pumsam vikalpa nihitatmanam. Sadhu sadhu tvaya prushta tantra saramidam priye. My dear, you have asked the best question ever. Correct. This is what one should know. And this is the tantra sara. It is the essence of the tantra shastra. Many people have got this notion, tantra means something horrible. No. Our whole religion is based on these three principles. One is yantra, second is tantra, and third is mantra. If you go to the temple, temple is the yantra. It is based on the, which is the vastu, real principle, this should be here, that is the yantra, machine. And when we go to the temple, then there is mantra. Then you have to chant Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, mantra. And tantra, how to do that? So, at the physical level, it is the yantra. At the action level, it is the tantra. And at the experience level, it is a mantra. So, in this manner, the whole thing is together. Many people have got this notion. I too had this thing. Mantra means all horrible. These aghoris and all. No, that is not the meaning. There are many subtle points in this. So, tantra saramidam priye. You have asked the best about the essence of the tantra. Then he says, guhaniya tamam bhadre tathami kathayamite. Although it is the highest secret, and yet I'll tell you, because you are dear to me. Bhagavan also says in Bhagavad Gita, Kehe Arjun, this Vishwarupa darshan you had, nobody, no gods did not have, because you are dear to me. This is through Bhagavad Gita. Go through Upanishad. Same principle, words are different. There it is said, Tad vidyanartham guru mevabhi gacche samit paanhi shrotriyam brahmanishtham. Aap gaye Guru Maharaj ke paas, jo shrotriya brahmanishtha hai. Phir, thereafter it is said that the truth reveals itself. See? The truth is not gained by our efforts, but the truth reveals itself. By prakata krupala dina dayala, Bhagavan is manifesting. It is not created, it is not the result of our action. See? Yamai vesha vrunute tena labhyaha. When the Lord decides, then He reveals Himself to that devotee. So here also, guhaniyatamam bhadre tathami katayamite, I shall tell you, although it is the most secret of all the secrets, guhaniyatamam. See, every word has a meaning. Guhaniya, guhaniyatara and guhaniyatama. This is called taratamya. Taratamya means infinitive, comparative and superlative. Like good infinitive, then better comparative and best superlative. Similarly, Guhya Shastra is Dharma Shastra. How to conduct ourselves in this world, when we accept ourselves to be body and thereafter mother, father, husband, wife, etc. How should we conduct ourselves? This is Guhya Shastra. Guhya Tara Shastra is how to invoke the divine grace through upasana. So upasana is Guhya Tara Shastra. And Guhya Tama Shastra is to come to discover your essential nature, who you are. So technically speaking, one is the Dharma Shastra, second is Upasana Shastra, and third is Adhyatma Shastra. Bhagavad Gita 15th chapter. This is very clearly and distinctly indicated. When Bhagavan talks about the adhyatmic sadhana, there He doesn't tell you all other things, but He says that one has to transcend the body identification. Thereafter, like, you know, nirmana moha, jain jita sanga dosha, then adhyatmanitya. Adhyatmanitya is this. Be aware of your being. World has been always like this. There is nothing new in this world. And this world will continue to be like this. Our effort is like my friend, we were in Goa, nicely having fun in the sea, beach side, and there are a few kids with me. And there was one elderly man, he also came with a towel around him and watching. I said, hey, come on, get in. What is there to watch? He said, no, I'm waiting for the waves to stop coming, then I'll come. I said, then you will be made into a statue, this Vivekananda. Waves will never stop. This is exactly the same thing all the through. Nothing new in this world. See? Getting married, not getting married. Having children, not having children. Getting job, not having job. Being successful, not being successful. What is new? Same thing goes on and on and on. See? But that becomes the only story of our life. The one who has risen above this, enough is enough, yaar. But we get so much attached to this, taking this to be real and suffer. Therefore, guhaniyatamam, that means, now I shall tell you the ultimate in our spiritual pursuit. Yat kinchit sakalam rupam bhairavasya prakirtitam. whatever is told about Paramatma, he is the creator, he is the sustainer, he is the destroyer, he blesses, he doesn't bless, he destroys the enemies and he destroys the bad people. See, yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam srujamyam paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya dushkruta. All these things is for whom? It is said, dhyanartham bhranta buddhi nam. It is for those who are dull-witted fools. See, friends. So, tad asarataya devi vidneyam. All that is told, that is not the essence. Asarataya. Then, shakra jalavat. It is like a magician's show. And sapna, maya sapno pamam chaiva. It's like an illusion which appears in the dream or in the maya or gandharva nagaram brahmam. Or like we see the clouds in the sky and we imagine this is that and all kinds of things. And all this is told because dhyanartham bhranta buddhi nam. Those who are deluded, they want some kind of support and they run after that. And who are they? Kriya adambara varti nam. Those who want to do something, they can't keep quiet. I want to do this, I want to do this, I want to do this. No end to that. See? And then they go from one Babaji to another Babaji. See? And that is how the Bakri Eid is celebrated. Do you know Bakri Eid, how it is celebrated? One person asked me this question. Swamiji, why this is called as Bakri Eid? That day it was Bakri Eid. I said, come on here, I'm not a Muslim, I don't know anything about it. He said, no, no, you know everything, please tell. I said, okay, listen. That day a bakra is slaughtered, therefore bakri enjoys. See, they'll be going from one Babaji to another Babaji and the Babaji says, chalo, mil gaya, kato. Don't run from one place to another place, from one person to another person. Discover your own divine self. It's called as self-discovery. Discover means what? What is already existing, but you do not know. So what is to be done? Remove the cover, the truth is revealed. And therefore it is not created. But those who are so much involved in karma, 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 they can't keep quiet. Then to such people, they are told, okay, you do one thing, you go around Kailash Parvat. 21 times. Then what will happen? You will never go again. How long? But they are so much involved in that. Therefore, dhyanartham bhranta buddhi nam kriya adambaravarti nam. And you will see wherever there is any karma kanda going on, too many things are there. And more karma kandi, more anger, frustration. Everything is there. Then it is kevalam varnitam pumsam vikalpa nihitatmanam. Those who are utterly destroyed because of so many imagination. And therefore they are told, see how we get lost in this. If somebody is a devotee of one god, he will refuse to go to other god. No, I am devotee there. Therefore, tattvato naiva naivatma shabda rashir na bhairava na chaso trishira devo na cha shakti trayatmakaha. Tattvataha, this paramatma tattva is not having the nine atmas or the words or the shabda rashi or with the three heads, jagra sapna sushupti or three powers, the sattva rajas tamas, nada bindu mayo vapi, the nada bindu kalati taha, no, chandrarka nirodhika, all these various stages, it has nothing to do, nacha shakti swarupakaha, nor it is having any power that the paramatma is, then aprabuddha mati nam hi eta bala vibhishika, aprabuddha mati nam. Those who are exclusively dull-witted fools. What is being dull-witted fool? One young boy asked me once a question in some college. Swamiji, have you seen God? So I said, I don't know what you mean by God. I don't know what is God, tell me. You don't know God? I said, no, you tell me. God is God. We use the words, but what is the meaning of that word? See? And when we don't have the meaning, then all funny things come up. See? So we simply say, God, God, God. What is a God? Therefore, aprabuddhamati namhi eta bala vibhishika. So like the children, they don't go to sleep. Then what the mother tells? Mother will try to create a fear in their mind. See, if you don't sleep, the ghost will come from that side and take you away. So the child, where is the ghost? This I tried once in Badrinath. That day this doubt was removed. There was one small child, now she is a big lady. She was that time maybe about 5 years or so. We travelled from Haridwar to Badrinath in bus, about a group of 20, 25 people. And she was sitting with me and sitting like a kangaroo facing me. And whole journey, she was nicely sleeping. Now I can't move here and there. When we reached there, she was fresh because she had a good sleep. Now we are all tired. When we want to sleep, she was telling, Papa, tell me some story. Papa said, no, 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 Mummy knows better story. Mummy said, no, 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 Swamiji knows better story. So she came to me. Swamiji, please tell me some story. I'm not feeling sleepy. And we are all damn tired. Then I told her, I said, look here, if you don't sleep, that side, you know, yes, darkness, yes, a ghost will come from there. Oh, ghost is coming, then I don't need you. How can you frighten a person who doesn't get frightened? See, about this I'll tell you my experience. Somewhere, one person asked me, hey, other religions man, do you believe in God, their God? Do you believe in God? I said, no. Don't you believe in God, you'll go to hell. I said, what about you, sir? He said, I'll go to heaven. I said, if you go to heaven, I'll prefer hell. Who wants to have a friend like you? This Bala Vibhishika is only by fear. You will see, majority of the people visit the temples, etc., never for the love for the Lord, but it is the fear. Who wants God? We want only get rid of fear. Therefore, Bala Vibhishika, Matru Modakavat Sarva, the second example is given. The children, now these days, these examples are outdated. The child is told, look here, if you come with 80% marks, you will get this. If you come with 90% marks, you will get this. If you get 100% marks, you will get this thing. Now the children have this thing right from birth. What can you tempt them? So why they are told this thing? So that they should study. But he who has all these things, you can't tempt him. Therefore, Matru Modaka Sarva. So therefore they say, if you do this karma, you will go to heaven. Now the one who knows, heaven is wherever you are. Hell is wherever you are. You don't have to go to a place. Heaven and hell, they are not the places. See, Swarga Loka. Loka means experience. Lokyate iti loka. So what is the heaven's experience? There is total freedom from 6 principles of life. Freedom from the old age and death with reference to the body. Freedom from hunger and thirst with reference to the prana. Freedom from joy, these delusion and grief with reference to the mind. These are the 3 things which are creating problems for us. No. They are not creating problem for us. When we are identified with them, then they create problem for us. When I am identified with the body, Then I become man, woman, young, old, etc. When I am identified with the prana, then I become hungry and thirsty. When I become identified with the mind, then I become cheerful or miserable. So, be very attentive. So, body is not a problem, prana is not a problem, mind is not a problem. Then, I is also not a problem. Where is the problem? The problem is with identification. See, friends, so what will be the sadhana? Freedom from identification. Now this you don't have to do anything, only learn. My friends, if you take this as your spiritual practice, every experience is our guru if we learn from them. See, about this I'll tell you. There was one Gujarati family in Mumbai. So they invited me for food, I went. And after food was over, then he said, Swamiji, our Dadi Ma is not well in the other room, please bless her. So I had to listen. Namak khaya tha. How can I say no? So I went there. And she was in coma. All the tubes here and there. And then there was a nurse. So I thank God there's somebody to talk. So I talked to her. I said, hey, are they paying you okay? Yes, Swamiji. I said, pray to the Lord. Till you get the next customer, she should continue. And when I was talking to her, those people came to see what Swamiji blesses. I have not blessed anybody till date. I don't know how to bless. See, friends, when you bless somebody, Ashirvad, you have to have clear acceptance that you are superior than others. The moment you become extraordinary, you are a samsari. Paramatma is ordinary. Mahatma hai, usme bhi hai. Gadha hai, usme bhi hai. Gadha Mahatma hai, usme bhi hai. It makes no difference to Paramatma. The truth is nirvishesha satta. See, friends. So, I took her hand in my hand and put my hand on her hand and I kissed my hand. Who will kiss that deadly hand? And then Natak. Who can challenge what I am doing? And after that was over, I went. Third day, that man came for satsang and he said, Swamiji, do you remember me? I said, I don't remember God. How will I remember you? He said, no, you came to our house and our Dadi Ma was not well. You blessed her. Then I said, my God, now what happened? My heart started beating, coming out of the chest. If my blessings have killed her, then my blessings kill. If she is alive, they have come to kill me. Phir jinda ho gai. Then he says, Swamiji, we could not see her suffering. She was suffering for last 6 months. And by your blessings, God has called her. She is now at peace with her God. I said, hey, whom are you cheating? You are cheating yourself. A person who is in coma never suffers. Then who suffers? The one who pays the bill. He suffers. Now tell me, why a person in coma doesn't suffer? Because that person is not identified with the body, not identified with the prana, not identified with the mind, but he's still there. So a person in coma is in swarga. Those who are paying the bill, they are in narak. See, friends. Therefore, don't imagine swarga is a place somewhere. But those who want to go to heaven, then they have to, you do this yajna, you do this thing, you do this dana, the dharma, then you will go to heaven. See, friends, Bhagavad Gita in 2nd chapter, Bhagavan very clearly says there, Kamatmanaha Svargapara Kriya Bahula Vishesham. They are so much full of desires. I want to go to heaven, therefore do this karma. Don't get carried away. See, one beautiful thought I heard. Like you go to a rich man's wedding, particularly if they are Gujarati and Punjabi, no end to the dishes. There will be so many dishes. Achar, 30 types. Then your farsan, 40 types. Then mukhwas, 60 types. This is only the supporting. The real dishes are many. So you go there. You see so many things. Then you take a parat. Are Baba, so many things are kept there for you to choose what suits you, and that only you eat. You don't have to eat everything. No, उन्होंने इतना प्यार से बनाया, अरे मारो. Exactly the same way in our scriptures, everything is told. Hell, heaven, karma, upasana, this, that, is it told. But you decide now, is it for you? See, find out what is really suitable for you. Then you will come to know you are at peace when you are only one. And you are only one, only in deep sleep. Therefore, go to sleep. But how to go to sleep is the secret of Vedanta. This is what is told here. So, the teacher is here telling that all these things are only those who are extremely involved in this activity, karma, all these things has no meaning. Dikkala kalanon mukta desho desha visheshini vyapadeshtu mashakyasau akathya paramarthataha. The truth is, beyond the limitations of all the directions, time, space, activity, etc. And then, desho desha visheshini. There is no specificity about one direction, this space, that place, and cannot be spoken of. Vyapadeshtum ashakya asav. Cannot be spoken of that it is like this or like that. Anta-Sw.Anubhavananda vikalpon mukta gocharaha yavasta bharitakara bhairavi bhairavatmana. Therefore, Anta-Sw.Anubhavananda, it is a matter of your personal immediate experience. Personal immediate experience means what? That experience in which there is no sense of otherness, that experience which has no means of knowledge required, that experience which is not created, that experience which doesn't undergo modification, that experience which has never ended, that is the same experience, although supporting all the varieties of experiences. See? Bhagavan Krishna, Bhagavad Gita, chapter 15. Sarvasya chaham hrudi sannivishtaha mattaha smriti jnanam apohanancha. I alone support smriti, dream, jnanam, waking, apohanam, deep sleep, chakarat, samadhi. I alone support jagra, sapna, sushupti, samadhi. And therefore, sarvaihi vedaihi aham eva vedyaha. What is worthy of knowing is this I. Who is this I? See, friends, this is what here it is said, that Anta-Sw.Anubhavananda. And when you get into this mode of contemplation, then this path of Vijnana Bhairava becomes easy. So, analyze your experience. Whenever we are disturbed, find out who is disturbed. You are following spiritual path. When you are disturbed, you ask a question, why I am disturbed? You are entering samsara. Then, I am disturbed because of her. You are buried in samsara. So when any experience takes us away from ourselves. We are a samsari. When any experience which brings us back to ourselves, we are the seekers. See, only this mistake, why I am miserable or who is miserable, this discrimination is not practiced. See? And therefore, we become somebody, and when we become somebody, we have expectation from other bodies. See, friends, the day this becomes a principle of our life, that whosoever is miserable, he is responsible for his own miseries. Nobody can make you miserable unless you cooperate with the miseries. See? Let somebody give miseries, but you refuse to be miserable. You have got a choice. You have to exercise this choice. Miseries are common to everybody, but all are not miserable because they have not chosen to be miserable. And those who are chosen to be miserable, they will find out the reason to be miserable. See? Therefore, Anta-Sva-Anubhavananda Vikalpon Mukta Gocharaha. No, there is no vikalpa, there is no option, there is no imagination. Meaning, thought-free, immediate, uncreated, unmodifying, unending, eternal presence is the truth. This is the ultimate. It is not subject to fear, loss. Bhagavan says, Sthitva syam antakalepi brahma nirvana mruchyati. Even if we attain this at the last moment when the body is dropped. See, friends, all this begins from the disease of identification. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is nothing but disidentify. See, like how identification. These taxi people are constantly traveling on that road, so they know. If there is a barrier, that you know, oblique kind of barrier rod is there. So when our car is going below that, we feel it will hit, we duck down. The car is above our head, you don't have to duck. But that identification, oh, it should not hit me. This habit of disidentification has to be given up. Therefore, Anta-Sva-Anubhavananda Vikalpon Mukta Mocharam. There is no Vikalva Yavasta Bharitakara Bhairavi Bhairavatmana. So, this is the divine principle, O Bhairavi, O Devi. Further, Tadvapustatvato Neyam Vimalam Vishwapuranam Evam Vide Pare Tatve Kapuja Kashyatrupyati. Now, from here, after having recognized this essential nature, what is the approach to life of that master is indicated. This we will take in our tomorrow's class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamidam.